Hello everybody, today we will discuss more about the chapter Story of Village Palampur. In the previous video, we discussed the various activities, various facilities, families and the main factors of production. We had a brief introduction about the various factors of production in the last video. These were land, labor, physical capital and human capital. Now we will discuss in detail one factor of production, that is the land. In Palampur, the main activity being undertaken by the people of that village is the farming. Around 75% of the people who are working, whether they are men or they are women, or they are farmer or they are farm laborers, they are all engaged in farming in this village. 75% of the people directly or indirectly depend upon farming for their livelihood. If dekha jaye beta, land is a most important factor of production, but land is fixed. Aap land ko increase nahi kar sakte. Jo hamare paas land hai, usi land ke beech mein humne apni agricultural activities karni hoti. इस विलेज में भी जो कुछ वेस्ट लैंड थे या जो कुछ आइडल लैंड्स पड़े थे, खाली ज़मीनें पड़ी थी या कुछ बंजर ज़मीनें पड़ी थी, उन सबको उन लोगों ने अपने एफर्ट से बंजर ज़मीनों को कल्टीवेबल लैंड में उन लोगों ने कन्वर्ट किया, ताकि कोई भी लैंड वहाँ पे आइडल ना पड़ा रहे. सारे लैंड्स को हम कल्टीवेशन में कन्वर्ट कर दें, कल्टीवेटेड लैंड में रहे, कोई भी बैरन लैंड ना रहे. So basically the various crops which are grown in this village are beautifully shown with the help of this pyramid. Kharif crops are grown there, sugarcane, rabi crops and potato. These are the main crops which are grown in this village. Kharif crops are basically mainly these are the crops jowar and bajra, and these are sown in rainy season. Barsaat ke mausam mein hum inko sow karte hain. Rabi crops ko hum basically hamara wheat aata hai aur inko hum grow karte hain, sow karte hain winter season mein. Then comes sugarcane, ताकि हमारी साइड कुछ भी ज़मीन हमारी खाली ना पड़ी रहे, इसलिए वो sugarcane भी वहाँ पे उगाया जाता है, जो कि autumn के सीज़न में उगाया जाता है. जितना थोड़ा बहुत जो हमारी ज़मीन खाली रह गई, उसमें जो farmers हैं वो potatoes को grow करते हैं. जो हमारे potatoes हैं वो अक्टूबर से दिसंबर के बीच में, during these 3 months, अक्टूबर, नवंबर एंड दिसंबर, इन मंथ्स के बीच में उसको ग्रो करते हैं. सो नो इन दिस वे नो एरिया इन दिस नो लैंड इन दिस विलेज रिमेन्स आइडल. ऑल ऑफ द लैंड इज अंडर द कल्टीवेशन. नाउ बेसिकली कम्स व्हाट आर द वेरियस मेथड्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन कल्टीवेशन. There are basically two. One is multiple cropping and next comes the modern farming. Now what is multiple cropping? Multiple cropping kya hota hai? This is basically growing more than one crop on the piece of land during the year is known as multiple cropping. एक ही जगह पे एक से ज़्यादा crop उगाने को हम multiple cropping कहते हैं. एक साल में एक जगह पे एक ही क्रॉप नहीं उगाते हैं, डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स उगाते हैं. इससे क्या होता है, आपकी लैंड की फर्टिलिटी बढ़ती है. द वेरियस क्रॉप्स विच आर ग्रोन इन दिस विलेज, दीज आर डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड. These are wheat, bajra, sugarcane and potato. The main crops which are grown in the village are wheat, bajra, sugarcane and potato. These are grown in the village on rotation basis. All these crops are grown on rotation basis so that the cultivity or fertility of the land increases and it leads to increase in the overall production in the of all the food grains which are grown during that period. Next comes the modern farming. In late 1960s, new methods of farming were evolved. These leads to the introduction of the Green Revolution. Green Revolution was basically introduced in late 1960s in the village Palanpur. What the Green Revolution is? Green Revolution is mainly it made use of high yielding varieties of seeds जिनको हम HYV seeds बोलते हैं. With the introduction of this Green Revolution, Indian farmers made use of these HYV seeds. In HYV seeds से क्या होता है, आपकी ये जो seeds है, high yielding varieties है, इनमें ज़्यादा manure, ज़्यादा fertilizers, ज़्यादा आपके water की ज़रूरत पड़ती है, जिसके कारण क्या होता है, आपकी production इसमें increase हो जाती है. With the old or obsolete methods of production, with this modern farming cannot be implemented. This modern method is basically adopted for rice and wheat production. It requires plenty of water. For this plenty of water, requirement, the introduction of tube wells was introduced in this way. First of all, government established new tube wells and then electrified tube wells were introduced by the people on their own so that there is a proper irrigation facility available in the village, which leads to increase in the production of all the food grains. Now, there is a small picture representing the production process. Harvest. Now, first of all, the crops are the soil is, we start from soil. Soil, all the waste soil or ideal soil is transformed into a cultivable land, and then the purchased fertilizers are put onto it, or the volatile loss is there, runoff and leaching loss is there, animal waste is there, and then with the help of tractors, they plow the land, farmers plow the land, and the new seeds are sown in the fields. Then with the help of water, sunlight, pesticides, insecticides, fertilizers and manures, the food crops are grown. Then these crops are harvested and then these are sold in the market, or these are being stored in the various containers so these can be used later on in the year. The various crops which are grown during the year, these are used for grazing for the animal feeds, and these are used for self consumption, and these animals who feed on the crops grown by the farmers, they give milk. And the animal waste, which are used as a manure by the farmers for in their soil, in their crops, and the milk and milk products are used by the people for self-consumption or for sale purposes. Now move further. Next comes the what is the impact of modern farming? With the use of more fertilizers, chemical fertilizers, in modern farming, the level of soil fertility has decreased. There is a continuous use of chemical fertilizers to increase the level of production. So the level of soil fertility has declined over the years. No more water is required in this. Irrigation facility is developed in the village. With the increased use of water, the water table level has declined. Due to the continuous use of tube well irrigation, there is a depletion of water table. Now comes the distribution of land between. I have drawn a beautiful pie chart to explain you the land, how the land is distributed between the farmers of Palambu. Between the various families, it is basically divided into three quarters. In the first quarter, which is shown with blue color, this shows the first quarter, which comprises of 240 families. The second quarter is of red in color, which shows 1/3 population, which is basically belongs to the SC category people. And the third quarter is of green in color, which shows the 60 families, details about the 60 families. So moving backwards to the first quarter, which involves 240 families, these families basically own very small plots. These families basically own very small plots, less than 2 hectares of land. छोटे छोटे प्लाट्स थे उनके पास. अगर आप अपनी एनसीईआरटी की बुक में भी देखोगे, छोटे छोटे प्लाट्स जो थे, ये 240 फैमिलीज के पास थे. बहुत बड़े लैंड्स नहीं थे ये. अपने लैंड्स खुद करते थे या फार्म लेबर्स वट एवर. वैसे वो इतने छोटे थे कि दे देमसेल्व्स एंगेज इन द एग्रीकल्चर वर्क. वो लोग उसमें खुद उगाते थे, सारा काम करते थे. तो लेस देन 2 हेक्टेयर्स ऑफ लैंड वर्क in world evolved by the well cultivated by the 240 families. Then comes to the second quarter. Second quarter involves 1/3 of the population. These people basically do not have their own land. उनके पास अपने land नहीं होते थे. ये 150 families थी, 150 families जो औरों के lands पे काम करते थे. They can work डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली एग्रीकल्चर के ऊपर डिपेंड करते थे. इनकी जो सोर्स ऑफ लाइवलीहुड था वो एग्रीकल्चर था. ये लोग क्या करते थे या तो ये औरों की ज़मीनों पे दिहाड़ी पे काम करते थे या लीज पे वो लैंड लेते थे और उस पर वो काम करते थे. एंड द थर्ड क्वार्टर विच इज़ ग्रीन इन कलर विच शोज़ द story of 60 families who have their own lands and they occupy the lands basically more than 2 hectares of area. 2 hectares se zyada unke paas cultivable land hota tha. Ab zyada land hone ke karan wo khud bhi jo itna kaam nahi karte the, ameer log the, to unhone aage farm labors hire kiye. Farm labors se wo ye kaam karwate the. सो 60 फैमिलीज के पास 2 हेक्टेयर से ज़्यादा लैंड था और बाकी के हमारी जो फैमिलीज हैं इस विलेज में, पालमपुर विलेज में, उनके पास या अपना लैंड नहीं था या बहुत. और 240 जो ब्लू कलर में आपको शो किया जा रहा है फर्स्ट क्वार्टर में, उसमें दिखाया जा रहा है कि ये आपके 2 हेक्टेयर से ज़्यादा लैंड उनके पास नहीं था. वो छोटे छोटे प्लॉट, 2 हेक्टेयर से कम के प्लॉट जो थे इन लोगों के पास थे. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट हाउ लैंड इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन दिस विलेज. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट दिस वीडियो. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट और यू कैन कॉन्टैक्ट और कमेंट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. थैंक यू.